Hey, what's up everyone? Jill here for Premier Basics, and today I'm going to teach you how to...
What are you doing?
We're gonna teach them how to talk to themselves, right?
No, Jill. Oh. We're going to teach them how to clone themselves.
Did someone say cloning? Let's clone pizza. I'm hungry.
Anyway, first let's make our shot. What we need is a tripod shot, and we're going to stand somewhere in the frame. Act our scene, keep the camera rolling, stand somewhere else, and act as the clone. You can keep on doing this for as many times as you need, of course. Now another way is to make a green screen shot, and we're going to do this outside because of the even lighting and with a small green screen because the edge of this keeps it tight, just as we want it to be. Now don't stand too close to your green screen, otherwise you will cast shadows on it. And of course, don't forget to shoot a clean plate afterwards as well. Now let's head over to Premiere Pro. We'll start with our first method, which is the easiest one actually. Now we place our tripod clip in the timeline and start placing cuts on every part where I am acting as a new clone. We can then place these on top of each other and match the acting so that it looks like I'm interacting with my clone. And what we now have to do is place a simple mask on the top clip, which we can do with the pen tool in the opacity property within the effect controls panel, or with the rectangle tool. And bam, here we have our final scene. If needed, you can always feather the mask a tiny bit, of course.
Hey Jill, let's do a stare down battle. Sure, I'm gonna win.
Oh no, you won't.
You know, I have this feeling that I'm being watched. Yeah, me too actually.
The next method is a tiny bit harder. Once again, we're first gonna cut everything so that the acting matches. And next we're going to place the empty clean plate on track number one, and all of the other clips we place above it. Now we select the top clip and make a rough mask around our subject in the green screen. And if needed, you can animate this by placing keyframes on the mask path. Once that's done, we're going to use the ultra key effect. Now from the effect controls panel, we select the color selector and select the green in our shot. Next, we're setting the output to alpha channel, and now you will see way more clearer what you are keying, because everything will be either black or white. The black parts are going to be removed, and white will be everything that remains in our shot. Then we use the highlight and shadow controls to make sure that our subject is displayed completely white and our background is completely black. Now try to get this as best as possible. And with the pedestal and transparency controls, you can get this even better. So also make sure to use those as well. Next, we're heading into the math cleanup dropdown and add a little bit of a choke. Now don't add too much though, because this will bite into your subject and we don't want to lose an ear or something else. Then use the soften property to feather the mask just a tiny bit. Now at the end, don't forget to put the output to composite again once you're done. Now here's a quick tip that I got from my colleague Janik. If you can't seem to get a proper green screen, first head over to the Lumetri control panel and with the HSL secondary tool, make a selection of the green in your shot. Then blur it a bit, and then pump the saturation and green tint to the max and lower the contrast to as low as possible. Now don't use the sliders for this, but place your mouse on the number and drag it. That way you will get a whole different maximum output. Okay, once our key is done, we can go and key the other shots. Now if your green screen and lighting stayed the same, we can actually use the same color key from the first clip and copy paste it. But maybe fine-tune each shot just a tiny bit to make sure that everything is looking perfect.
So just like in Star Wars, we are all clones. But of course, we all know that I am the real one.
No, I'm the real clone.
No, Jill, I am the real one.
No, I'm the original one.
Hell no, I'm the original one.
Hell no.
Wait, but if it's not me and it's not you, then maybe it's the guy in the back over there.
And voila, here we have our two ways to create a clone of yourself. Now, keep in mind that you can't physically interact with your clone because that's more advanced. So there's no playing tag with your clone or punching him in the face or in the stomach, but maybe that's for another time. If you enjoyed this tutorial and want even more cool Premiere Pro tips and tricks, then definitely have a look at our classes on Skillshare. We have a beginner's class and an advanced class about Premiere. And we also have a class completely dedicated to color grading in Premiere. So check out the link below and have a look at our classes. I'll see you guys next week. And as always, Come on, say it, Jill. Stay creative.